Okay, so we finally have the latest version of Windows 11 and it was just released as a developer preview. That means that it is still half-baked and an early preview of what's yet to come for this latest Windows version. And full disclaimer, well, I love this redesign as it feels futuristic. So without wasting any more time, let's quickly check out the top 10 Windows 11 features that I love so far. And before we move further, make sure you tap on that subscribe button so that I can make more videos like this one in future. Also, some of you must be wondering, like, I wish to try this one too, and you can do it quite easily. But I won't advise you to bother your daily driver. Anyways, to get the access to this developer beta one, all you have to do is go into the Windows settings, here go to updates, and now click on this Windows Insider program. Here you will see three options, beta, dev beta, and a release preview. So just select developer beta from the options and now sign in with your Microsoft account and you are almost set. After this, just check in your system updates and you will get a OTA instantly that will install Windows 11 on your laptop or your PC. So just let it install and it will take some time to install as it is one of the biggest update to Windows in the past few years. Anyways, let it install and then click on this reboot button and there you go. Now you are on the latest Windows 11 developer preview 1. So right from the lock screen, this clock surely feels changed. It is now centered instead of cornered and that feels more natural to me. My device is running on Intel i5 9th gen and it has 16GB of RAM. So here are some Geekbench scores that I got after this update. Now let's jump into the features one by one. And the first feature that you can instantly see with this Windows 11 is this new start menu. And yeah, it is now centered, which feels more in line with macOS, but being honest here, I kind of like this one, as it has its own glassy effects going on and it looks really neat visually. The start menu has changed entirely too and feels less cluttered now, and the animated tiles are also gone with this update. The search bar also feels faster because dear Cortana is gone, finally, and in Windows 10, I hated it when the start button did not respond instantly. And now I have no complaints with this one. Well done, Microsoft. Next up, the notification shade has also changed drastically and looks very minimal now with each tile spaced well from each other. And again, this is a welcome change as I found the older notification panel to be a mess most of the time. And something similar has happened with the calendar app and it looks a bit polished and gives a better user experience. Also, there are new animations almost everywhere, from opening and closing of applications to the jumping of icons in the taskbar and whatnot, which looks really good and fluid. The next big feature I like is memory docking and multitasking improvements. So first up, whenever you hover over the maximize icon, it now gives you four options to resize your windows. And this is a game-changing feature that enables seamless multitasking between the applications. And for someone like me who switches over again and again between the applications, well, this is amazing, as it enables using all the apps I want in one single screen. And you can make the most of your time just with this nifty feature. Also, this multitasking craze doesn't end here. Remember the last time when you had to disconnect the secondary display and all your applications came to the primary display and looked like a mess? Well, say no more. Now we have this memory docking ability that keeps in mind how and which apps you had on your second screen. And whenever you plug in your display back, it will show all the applications arranged in the similar way that you had before. And this is a neat feature that I really don't know why it was not there on Windows before, as it is going to be really helpful in many scenarios. Kudos to Microsoft for this. Next up, we have the new Microsoft Store that has been completely redesigned. And you can see how neat it looks and scales from smaller to a bigger display and so on. The apps and everything are also arranged neatly now and I like this hover effect thingy. The UI redesign is in line with the whole system theme and looks quite useful now, as you can easily find your apps and games on the go with this one. And yeah, this build does not have any Android app support, just in case you were wondering. Hopefully that should come later this year. After that, we have the all new widget menu that has all your to-dos, newsfeed, reminders, weather info and a lot more. So they are all arranged in this neat glass-like sheet, which looks kinda cool. After this, we have the all new settings and they are totally redesigned now. So the most of the data is now in card list format, which not only looks good and feels better, but it is more convenient too. The UI overall looks good and is pretty functional, to be frank, and my initial impressions with it are quite positive. Inside this menu, we have a couple of important things, and first one is the theme support. So now we have 6 different themes by default to suit your mood, and they are, well, chef's kiss amazing. The colors used and the way they are redesigned look aesthetically pleasing, and this doesn't end here. You can download hundreds of themes from the App Store and even make your own, which is awesome. And this is really good for those who like to customize their PC, and again, an amazing feature that you should surely try. Though still there are some slowdowns and other issues with theming engine, and it messes up from time to time. After that, we have the gaming mode, and now you can manage which graphics card games and apps should use. And you can also manage your recordings and screenshots from this games application. So that is going to be helpful for you gamer souls out there. Next up, we also have auto HDR support with this version of Windows. And if your display supports it, well, Windows can now play your videos automatically in HDR. And that should sum up to a better media experience overall. Lastly, we have this new UI redesign in most of other places. For example, we have the new icons in my computer, and all Windows have these rounded cards that look more clean visually. The refresh toggle is now hidden in Show More Properties option, and you can now switch over to vertical tabs in Microsoft Edge, which is good too. So these are some of the great features that I found so far in my short time with this Windows 11. And it looks like this is going to be an interesting update for users, as it carries over a major UI redesign, something that users will definitely like. And my early impressions are really great with this new Windows 11. Anyways, that's it for now, and if you end up liking this video, make sure you press that subscribe button and press the thumbs up button while you are at it. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.